J cuts and L cuts are a classic editing approach that allows you to blend the contents of two scenes. It's a little bit more than a cross dissolve or a crossfade. When you perform a J cut or an L cut, the audio from one scene merges into the next, giving the sense that that scene in some way impacts or relates to the other. I've got a perfect example in this sequence. I have a noisy opening shot and then a relatively quiet dialogue scene. Let's take a look.
Excuse me.
It's quite abrupt, and that might be what you want to achieve creatively. But let's see if we can merge these together. I'm going to zoom in the timeline panel so we can see the join between these two clips. And right now, I have linking turned on the timeline. So when I select one of these clips, for example, the video part of the building smooth clip, I'm getting its audio as well. If I click this button at the top left of the timeline panel, linked selection, and then deselect by clicking on the background of the timeline or hitting the escape key, now I can click on any item in this sequence and linking is ignored. It's still there. Premiere Pro still knows that those video and audio clips are connected, but the linking is being ignored for now. You can achieve a similar result, if I turn this back on, by holding Option on macOS or Alt in Windows. Again, though, I'll switch this off for now and deselect. Next up, I have to decide whether I want the video to come early or late. Let's start out by having the video come early. I'm going to hold Command here on macOS. This is Control in Windows, and just drag this edit left. By holding down that modifier key, I'm getting a dual roller trim instead of a regular or a ripple trim. That means the first clip gets shorter by exactly the amount the second clip gets longer. Now let's take another look. I'll click back a little and press the spacebar to play the video. Well, we're certainly getting the impression of one scene affecting the other, but it's very clumsy. There's a big jump when the audio stops from the previous scene. So now I'm going to hold Command again, and this time I'm going to drag up over this edit to select it. It's the same effect, really, as clicking. And now I'm going to use a keyboard shortcut to add an audio crossfade. If you press Command or Control D, you'll get a video transition. If you press Shift, Command or Control D, you'll get an audio transition. But if you just press Shift D, you'll get the default transition for whatever the media type is that you select. So you could quickly add transitions to lots of clips. Let me show you that right here. I'm lassoing to select. I'm pressing Shift D. Everything gets a cross dissolve or a crossfade. I'll just undo and deselect. But in this case, I'm selecting a transition and pressing Shift D, and I know I'm going to get an audio crossfade because it's audio. I'm going to want this crossfade to be much longer so that the transition is not obtrusive. So let's pull that out and have another look.
Excuse me.
Much better. There's a quick way to achieve a J cut or an L cut using the Shift Q or Shift W keyboard shortcuts as well. With linking turned off as it is now, I can position my playhead where I'd like the video cut to be, turn off the audio track because I'm only working on the video one track, and now if I press Shift Q, I'm performing an extend edit from the beginning of the clip. Shift W would extend the end. This is exactly the same result as me performing a dual roller trim. And of course, as you've probably guessed by now, an L cut is simply called an L cut because it creates an L shape. The video comes in before the audio. A J cut creates a J shape. The audio comes in before the video. If you want more subtle control over a J cut or an L cut, of course you can put your audio on different tracks and use manual keyframing to gently ease the audio out of one scene and into another. But more often than not, an audio crossfade will do the trick.